So this is Sam Lowe here for IrishBoxing.com. Delighted to be joined by Ben Davis and trainer to Lee Wood, the WBA Featherweight World Champion. We're here at the Wood Conlon press conference in the Europa Hotel in Belfast. Obviously the second leg of the press tour here, Ben. You've come under a little bit of scrutiny today. Just talk me through the press conference and just, yeah, a little bit of a reaction to the press conference today.
Yeah, of course. Obviously, today we was in Mick's town, so a lot of support for Mick. The glove stuff and that, all very predictable. But, you know, all fun and games as well. But all that matters really is obviously what happens in the ring on the night, March 12th.
100%. Obviously, yesterday and today, particularly yesterday, Jamie and Michael kind of came at you with, I suppose, allegations, if you like, that you had said to people in Sky Sports that you didn't believe in Lee against Rhys Mould, etc. What do you think the ploy is there? It might be an obvious question, but what do you think they're trying to do there by kind of... Are they trying to goad you there with a question like that?
I don't really know, to be honest. There's a big difference between saying you think someone's going to lose a fight or if they don't do what I say, they have the potential to lose the fight. Big difference there, but whatever they feel like they can take from it, then that's fine with me. As I say, what matters is on the night, March 12th, and I believe my man's going to come out victorious.
100%. Obviously, you've talked a lot about Lee's power. He does have a lot of power, but you're the type of trainer, from what I can see, who's into technique, who's kind of very nuanced. You're a forward-thinking young trainer. So for you, I would assume that power is not the only thing and perhaps not the thing that's going to win this fight for you. So talk to me about that. Like, you know, a lot of people like to talk about power and they kind of, for me, they dumb it down a lot with, oh, he is so powerful, so he's going to win the fight. Which, you know yourself, power is not everything. So can you talk to me a little bit about that?
Yeah, obviously, I've been very vocal about Lee's power, but he's always been able to punch and didn't have the same success before, so clearly that's not the be-all and end-all. The reason why it's mentioned so much in this fight is because I believe there's too many tendencies that leave potential fight-changing moments for Lee not to be able to exploit it.
Okay, you're not going to give us any of them, unfortunately not. But so I suppose to stick with the press conference a little bit, like, how does the hostility of a press conference like this, and it wasn't overly hostile, but there was a bit of hostility, and you're coming yourself is coming under scrutiny. Does that affect you in any way, or do you kind of just brush it off? And how does it affect Lee, do you think, as you approach the fight, as you start kind of get heavy into training camp?
Yeah, no, I mean, you can't afford to be emotional, really. I mean, yesterday there was a few things. Lee got a cheer from making a funny comment or whatever, and today the roles were reversed. So, you know, it's neither here nor there. They say that talk is cheap. It's not cheap because it helps sell tickets and promote the fight and all the rest of it, but it doesn't win fights. And what wins fights is the preparation and obviously following the preparation on the night.
Fair. Michael Conlon as an opponent, what does he bring to the table? And I'm interested in, you know, the Kanzu win for Lee was a brilliant win, but perhaps, you know, people might say that Kanzu was not at his optimum, at his best on that night. He hadn't fought for a long time. Michael Conlon, on the other hand, is up and coming, undefeated, and has boxed a good level in his last couple of fights. Who do you think is a kind of a harder fight, stylistically more difficult fight, etc.?
Between
Kanzu and Michael Conlon for Lee Wood, which is a more difficult fight?
Yeah, stylistically, Mick. But the people that say that Kanzu wasn't optimum for the fight and come up with these reasons why he didn't let his hands go don't know boxing, because they cannot see the fundamental things that Lee was doing to nullify. I can't go into it in too much detail because obviously it's my philosophy and it's certain things that Lee will be doing on the night, but there's a reason why Kanzu wasn't able to let his hands go.
And you believe it was solely down to Lee Wood and the plan and how he was able to execute the plan?
Of course. I mean, he throws punches all the time. He has the record for the most punches thrown in a featherweight title fight. For Lee to be able to drop that number down, it wasn't just, oh, inactivity, ridiculous. And as I say, anybody that's got to say that, doesn't bother me because you don't know what you're looking at or talking about.
No, 100%. I mean, anyone who knows high-level sport, especially individual sport, will know that, what Lee was doing was able to keep Kanzu out. Perhaps there may be a bit of both in it as well, but of course, from your point of view, there wasn't. But yeah, it was just an interesting one. But I don't really have anything else for you, Ben, but I want to say thanks very much for your time. I appreciate it, mate.